गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो वंस अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ द एशियन सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्कूल. दिस इज द चैप्टर नंबर 2 इन केमिस्ट्री. दिस इज सॉल्यूशन. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक मोल, मोलैरिटी, मोलैलिटी, नॉर्मैलिटी एंड मोल फ्रैक्शन. दिस इज most important part of the chapter, and it is numerical based. First point is mole, then molality and mole fraction. So first of all, what is mole? As you know, in class 10th, you have studied about the mole, the amount of any substance which have equal entities as 12 gram carbon 12 contain, that will be called 1 mole of that substance. First of all, the discovery based on the carbon 12 gram carbon 12 contain 12 gram carbon 12 contain 6.023 into 10 raised to the power 23 atoms. So according to this number, this is called the Avogadro's number. Number of entities, that means atoms, ions or molecules, equal to the 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. If you have taken the 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms, ions or molecules of any species, and you weigh these number of entities, that mass will be equals to 1 mole. So according to the definition, once again I'm telling to you how you will reply the mole. Mole is the amount of substance which have equal entities as 12 gram carbon 12 contain. And the formula of the mole, how you will calculate the number of moles, moles is equals to gram mass upon molecular mass or molar mass. As you know, every substance have its a molar mass. Like H2SO4, its molecular mass or molar mass is 98. These masses means the sum of the atomic masses of all the elements present in it. And the gram mass, which is given by weighing of any substance. Suppose question is this: calculate the number of moles in 120 gram acetic acid. So what we have to do, first of all, we have to find out the molecular mass or molar mass of acetic acid. And second is, this is 120 gram, this is the gram mass. We have to put the value of gram mass here and molar mass of acetic acid here. So solution, how you have to write the solution of this? Molar mass of CH3COOH. I have written the name here and you have to find the formula. Formula of acetic acid is CH3COOH, and after that we have to calculate the molar mass. Carbon, it's 12 plus 1 into 3 hydrogen, that's mean 1, and 3 hydrogens plus 12 plus oxygen, that's mean 16. There are 2 oxygens, 16 into 2 plus 1. So this will be equals to 60. This is the molar mass. And now you have to write the formula. Mole is equals to, that's mean N is equals to W upon mm. N is mole, W is gram mass, mm is molar mass, n is equals to gram mass, it is given this 120 divided by 60, that's equal to 2 moles. That's mean 120 gram of acetic acid will be called 2 mole. According to the chemistry, mole is a SI unit, and most of the numerical solved according to the mole. Gram is given, you can convert easily into mole. If mole is given, you can convert into gram mass also. One more question for you at homework. Calculate the number of moles in 19.6 gram H2SO4. So you have to do this question for today. And now moving towards the next topic, that is molarity. Students, as you know, molarity is a part of a concentration. It is indicated by capital M. When we prepare any solution, we dissolve the solute in any solvent. After dissolving solute in solvent, you will get a complete solution. In the solution you have, there are two things. One is solute, another is solvent. Mixture of solute and solvent, that will be called the solution. If you take some amount of solute in any liquid, suppose you have taken any solvent, this is solvent. Suppose you have taken 100 ml of this solvent. Any solvent, not it is compulsory to take the water, some other solvent, carbon disulfide, carbon tetrachloride, benzene, etc. And you are going to add some amount of solute. You have added some amount of solute. When you will add this solute, the level of the solution will increase. First, you have taken 100 ml of solvent, but after adding the solute, the complete solution is more than 100 ml. This is your volume of solution. Volume of solution. And these you are seeing that solute you have added. How much mole you have added in this? This will be the molarity. That's mean number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution will be called the molarity. Molarity is defined as the number of moles of solute. Number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. Dear student, you have to note down this definition. This is most important. There are 3 important things in this definition. Number of moles of solute, 1 liter solution. Means there should be no mistake in the volume here. It should be 1 liter. And solution, you should not write here solvent. Okay. Because what you have taken here 100 ml. But after adding the solute, the volume will increase. It will not be 100 ml. It will be more than 100 ml. So when you will going to calculate the molarity, you have to observe that the number of moles of solute must be present in the 1 liter of the solution. And it is indicated by the M. After the definition, we are going to the formula. Molarity is equals to number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liter. That should be in liter. So if you want to calculate, so capital M is equals to NB B means the solute we are indicating, and upon V in liter, that's mean volume of solution in liter. This is mole, mole of solute upon volume. If you want to write the formula in terms of the gram mass, so molarity capital M is equals to WB upon MM, this is molecular mass, into V. In place of number of moles of solute, we can write WB upon MB, because mole is equals to gram mass upon molecular mass. And what will be the unit of the molarity? You know, this is mole, this is liter. So unit of molarity, mole per liter. Or you can say molar or capital M. As you are seeing in the formula, that's volume is present in the denominator. So if you change the temperature on dissolving the solute in the solvent, definitely the volume of the solution will change with the temperature according to the Charles law. So dear student, molarity will vary with the temperature. That's mean you can say molarity is dependent upon temperature. Get it? And one more important point you have to note down. In some cases in the numerical, some coding should be written like molar. Molar solution means molarity 1 mole per liter. In somewhere in the question it is given, this is a molar solution, calculate the amount of the substance. So if it is written molar solution, that means its molarity is 1 mole per liter. If semi-molar, that's mean molarity 1 upon 2 mole per liter. Similarly, centimolar means molarity 1 upon 100 mole per liter. So now I'm going to solve one numerical. Okay, students. So question, calculate the molarity if 12.6 gram nitric acid is dissolved in 500 ml of solution. How you have to write the solution? So here we have to calculate the molarity of nitric acid. Nitric acid, the formula of nitric acid is HNO3. First of all, we have to calculate the molecular mass MM of HNO3. This is equals to 1 plus 14 plus 16 into 3. That's equal to 63. Now the molarity M is equals to WB upon MM into V in liter. WB, that's mean 12.6 gram it is given. Molecular mass you have calculated here, 63. And volume it is given 500 ml. That's equal to 0.5. We have to write the volume in liter. So 500 ml, that will be equal to 0.5. So you can write 126 upon 63 into 5. This is 1. 63 is 2 by 5. Or you can say 0.4 mole per liter. This is the solution. That means when you dissolve the 12.6 gram in 500 ml solution nitric acid, so molarity of the solution will be 0.4 mole per liter. Another question to you, what mass, you have to do this question, please note down, what mass must be dissolved टू प्रिपेयर एम बाई 50 250 ml मोहर सॉल्ट सॉल्यूशन, मोहर सॉल्ट्स सॉल्यूशन। डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट न्यूमेरिकल बिकॉज मोहर सॉल्ट सॉल्यूशंस इट इज योर प्रैक्टिकल आल्सो। इन टाइट्रेशन यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर दिस सॉल्यूशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वेट, हाउ मच मास। इन दिस क्वेश्चन रिवर्स ऑफ दिस, दिस इज द मोलरिटी गिवन टू यू, यू पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ मोलरिटी हेयर। डब्ल्यू बी दैट्स मीन मास ऑफ द मोहर सॉल्ट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट। मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ मोहर सॉल्ट आई एम गिविंग यू द हेल्प। द फार्मूला ऑफ मोहर सॉल्ट NH4 होल टूज एस ओ फोर डॉट FeSO4 डॉट 6H2O। You have to calculate the molar mass of Mohr salt and put the value of Mohr salt here. Volume is given, that is 250 ml, so you have to write 0.25. After that you have to calculate the mass of the substance. Now moving towards the next topic, that is normality. As you have seen in the molarity, number of moles of the solute dissolved per liter of the solution. Similarly, in the normality, in the normality, number of gram equivalent of the solute, gram equivalent is another type of entities, number of gram equivalent dissolved in 1 liter of solution. So dear student, how you will find out the gram equivalent? As you know, the mole is equals to gram mass upon molecular mass or molar mass, you can find the mole. Similarly, gram equivalent, that's mean gram equivalents equals to gram mass upon equivalent mass. So if you want to find the normality of any substance, any solution, so normality is equals to WB, this is the mass, upon E, this is equivalent mass, into V in liter. And the unit of the normality, that will be gram equivalent per liter. Or you can say N. In this also you are seeing the volume is present in the denominator, so normality also dependent of temperature, because on increasing or changing the temperature, volume will change according to the Charles law. Now I'm writing one numerical. Calculate the normality of H2SO4 solution when 19.6 gram H2SO4 is dissolved in 800 ml of solution. So dear student, how you have to do? First of all, we have to find out the molar mass, mm of H2SO4. 1 into 2 plus 32 plus 16 into 4, that's equal to 98. This is the molar mass, and you are seeing there are two hydrogen. It is a dibasic acid. So equivalent weight E is equals to 98 upon 2, that's mean 49. Now we have to put the formula. Normality is equals to gram mass upon equivalent mass into volume. N is equals to gram mass, that is given in the question, 19.6 upon equivalent mass, that is equals to 49. And volume in the question, it is given 800 ml. You have to convert this volume into liter, that's mean 0.8. So see here, 996 upon 49 into 8. This will be 4. 1 by 4, 2 is 8. That's mean 2. You can say N. So it is enough for today, dear students. And two topics are still left. We will meet again tomorrow with the next topic, that will be the molality and the mole fraction. Please solve the numericals. Goodbye.